परेवा शरणम, ग्लिम्सेस फ्रॉम श्री महापेरेवास लाइफ हिस्ट्री, वॉल्यूम 7, चैप्टर 16, कंटिन्यू। पंडित पंचानन तर्क रत्नास वेलकम। इन बंगाल, पंडित पंचानन तर्क रत्ना वॉज अ हाईली रेस्पेक्टेड स्कॉलर। ही सर्व्ड एज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द बंगाल ब्राह्मण सभा। इन रेस्पॉन्स टू एन इन्विटेशन फ्रॉम द बंगाल सभा, Mahaperyava visited the Sabha's office in Calcutta. In his welcome address in Sanskrit to Mahaperyava, Pandit Panchanana Tarka included the following significant remarks. The city of Calcutta in Gowda Mandal is newly built. It does not seem to have any historical fame. On researching the ancient treatise, Brihat Samhitai, authored by Varaha Mihirar, this region seems to have existed as sandy plains about 2,500 years ago. Even after the Europeans settled here, this place did not have full facilities for human habitation. It seems that for a long time, the city was not really blessed by the visit of great Mahans like you. We are indeed fortunate to receive you, the 68th Acharya of Sri Adi Shankara's Kamakoti Peetham and Jagadguru. I had the opportunity to see and perform some research on Shiva Rahasyam, a rare and ancient scripture carefully preserved in the library of Kashi Maharaja. In the scripture, it is mentioned that after establishing four mutts, Dwaraka, Jagannath, Badrinath and Sringeri, in four different directions, Sri Adi Shankara established for himself the Sarvajna Mutt in Kanchipuram, where he attained Siddhi. It is also learnt from an old book titled Anandagiri Shankara Vijayam that Sri Sureshwaracharya, a disciple of Adi Shankara, lived near Kanchipuram and he oversaw the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham established by his guru Sri Adi Shankara. You have inherited the generic name of Indra Saraswati. It reminds one of the Vedic words Indro Maya Bihi Pururupa Iyate. The combination of the word Indra signifying Paramatma Vachakam and the word Saraswati signifying Ananda of Brahma Vachakam highlight your high qualities of Brahman. Some people say that right from the days of Sri Sureshwaracharya, the Acharyas of the Kanchi Peetham acquired this title of Indra Saraswati. Coming in this great lineage of Acharyas and installing Sri Chakra just as Adi Shankara did, you have been traveling all over India without using any modern means of transportation. We consider ourselves very fortunate to have you in our midst and offer our respects to you. We do not know how to praise a great person like you with such amazing qualities. My speech stutters, my throat whimpers, my eyes are filling up with tears of happiness. On this auspicious day, we welcome you with Jaya Ghosham, sound of victory, as our Acharya who follows the Sanatana Dharma. The gathering applauded the speech of Pandit Panchanana Tarka. Sharada Navaratri. On September 28, 1935, celebrations started for Sharada Navaratri. In Bengal, this festival is celebrated in a grand scale. Mahaperyava performed the Navaratri Puja at the home of Sri M. Subramanian, who served at that time as Bengal's accountant general. The expenses for the puja on all days of Navaratri were borne by the local citizens that included Bengalis, Gujaratis, Marwaris and South Indians. On this auspicious event, women were worshipped and given gifts on all the 9 days of the festival. On October 6th, Mahapariyava performed Saraswati Puja and Chandi Homam in Calcutta. The following day, Vijayadashmi, Mahapariyava continued his Vijaya Yatra. Prominent personalities in Calcutta. There were numerous people who were closely associated with Mahapariyava and recipients of his blessings. Among them, some of the prominent personalities in Calcutta included Calcutta High Court Judge Sri Manmathanath Mukherjee, High Court Judge Sri Dwarakanath Mitra, Sri Sharat Chandra Bose, brother of freedom fighter Subhash Chandra Bose, the Maharaja of Bardwan, Sri Damodar Das Khanna. In Calcutta, Sir C.P. Ramaswamy Iyer, member of the Indian government's governing council, had darshan of Mahapariyava and had a long discussion with him. Mahapariyava's visit to Calcutta is an historical event for Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham. The reason for this is the deep devotion of the people of Calcutta and the services provided by them. Mahapariyava in Midnapur. Continuing his Vijay Yatra in Bengal, Mahapariyava travelled via Janardanpur and reached Midnapur on the new moon day of October 27, 1935. Background. Midnapur is about 70 miles west of Calcutta. It is the headquarters of Midnapur district. This city has served as a foundation for India's freedom movement. Many of the freedom fighters who had bravely faced the gallows were the sons of the soil of Midnapur. In those days, any freedom movement against the government was viewed as a dangerous activity. In Midnapur, there were strict government restrictions on any form of public meetings. Government had imposed a curfew impacting movement of people after 9 p.m. in the night. For many years, such government restrictions were in place in Midnapur. Though people were not free, they had very deep feelings about getting freedom. So, despite the government restrictions, the people of Midnapur decided to invite Mahapariyava to their city. Within a few hours of making this decision, the local people quickly set up a reception committee. To personally invite Mahapariyava, some members of the reception committee proceeded to Janardanpur, where Mahapariyava was camping at the time. Mahapariyava knew about the government restrictions but graciously accepted their invitation. On hearing this, the people conveyed the news of Mahapariyava's visit to Midnapur to the district collector and higher officials in Calcutta. The government made the people happy by relaxing the restrictions on the day of Mahapariyava's visit to Midnapur. The local people rejoiced this gesture and considered the day as Independence Day. To be continued, Periyava Sharanam.